Hello viewers, welcome back to the channel, thanks for joining me. As you're probably already aware, I make a lot of pencil projects. And because I make a lot of pencil projects, I end up with a load of off-cut pencils. I've got these, and I've got these. Because I chop them off because I don't need the ends when I'm making my pencil blanks. But never chuck anything away because you can always use it, whether it's a piece of wood or some pencils or whatever. Oh, look, there's more of them over here, look. Just notice these ones. I've got absolutely tons of bits and pieces and loads of pencils. So I looked at that and I thought, you know what? That would make a really cool pot. Yes, another pencil pot, but again, different. Just mixed up differently, set differently, designed differently. As you know, I never really know how my projects are going to come out, but I really enjoy doing it that way because it's more interesting for me to work out what it's going to be, more interesting for you as well, because you don't know what it's going to be, although you've probably seen the picture at the beginning of the video. But it's just nicer, I think, because I don't know. This could come out like that, and it could be a pot like that. But then it could end up being a vase. So what I've done, what I've prepared earlier, is I've prepared a couple of little tiny blanks. I wouldn't really call them bowl blanks, but they're round blanks. And I've chopped them in half and sanded them down. So this is my plan. Right, let's empty all of these out onto here. There we go. Let's get rid of that. So there's all my pencils. Now, I am gonna go through the painstaking process of just cleaning them all up a little bit first before I dump them in the pot, and also clean the pot out as well. So let me do that first. Okay, so I've cleaned up the pencils. I've just done that because there was a lot of dust on them and I didn't really want to get any of the dust in the project, really, because you'll probably see it, especially if we're going to fill it with clear resin. So I've cleaned the pot up inside, it's fairly clean, just the outside is dirty. So I've got these little blanks. Now the idea here is to put one in the bottom and one in the top and then fill the middle with all the pencils. So I'm just going to do that now. Right, so I just pop that on there. That's sort of set there. So that will be set into the resin now as well. So so that will make our lid and that will make our base. It looks quite nice. I think that that's going to look really quite cool. So we'll leave that to set in the pressure pot overnight, and then we'll bring that out when it's done. So there it is, popped it out, came out really nicely. Again, didn't oil this up, no idea why. So maybe you know why that is, but I've always learned that you need to oil up your containers or molds, but turns out that actually you don't. It's much better without oiling it up. I don't know, again, maybe it's the resin that you use. So here we go. So this is just popped straight out, nice and easy. Now this is the error that I thought might happen, where you fill it all up and it looks like you've got enough resin in there, but you haven't, and you can see that it's sunken down, it's left big gaps here. So what I could do now is I could put this back in here, fill the gaps with the resin, leave it again overnight. But I'm a bit impatient and I don't want to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to chop this off here with on the bandsaw, it'll be fine. I'm going to sand this down, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue this block back onto here. Now, yes, some of you might say, well, you're going to have to leave that overnight anyway. Yes, I am. so I can't really finish it today. But I'd rather do that and make and then glue it back on about here, knowing and then that's a perfect blank ready for me to make the pot. That's what I want to do. But it looks pretty cool. I think this is going to look quite smart. So, there we go. Taking that off, I'll put that through the sander, and that's now ready to glue back on there. Perfect. Get that glued back on, clamp that down, leave it overnight. All right, this is gonna look quite cool. Okay, everyone, here's that little pencil pot we glued up. All those little pencils in there. That's ready now to turn, make something. I turn it, make it. That's ready now to get on the lathe. Let's do it. Right, I found a new angle for you. Looking straight down. Let me know if you like that idea of it. I don't really know where to put the camera sometimes, but hopefully it's been all right for you. But this one, yeah, viewing down, so hopefully that's all right. Okay, so what I want to do is, obviously this is the base, and this is going to be the lid. I'm just going to get this, turn this to round first, just so we can get some sort of cylinder shape out of it. Right, so you've seen what I've done so far. So what I'm doing now is I'm getting it ready to mount in the chuck, the other side. So I'm finishing the bottom. So this is the best way to do this, I've found anyway. Again, I'm no expert, so I'm just giving you ideas of what I do and how I do it. So I've finished the bottom, just finishing the bottom off here now, so you can see. Got this ready for my emblem, and again, you know, you don't have to do that. It depends upon whether or not you're going to have an emblem in there or not, but that's up to you. So that fits in there quite nicely, I think. Kind of getting used to that now, so that, yeah, that fits in there quite nicely there. Oh, come on, out you come. So I'm just going to now put a one coat of sanding sealer on this. And you've got to put the sanding sealer on, and that sort of seals the wood. I use the Chestnut sanding sealer, which is a really good product, and I haven't found anything that's better than that, really. So one coat of that, and again, I'd prefer to put it on without the lathe running, just so I know I've got everywhere. But you can do, you can put it on with the lathe running, some people do, but I just prefer to sort of stop it, and then I'll sort of work it in afterwards like this. Right, so once I put one coat, what you want to try and do is put at least two or three coats of sanding cedar on it. Two's fine. So there's, now what I'm going to do is sand that back again, but I'm going to go down on the grits. So this one was, I think, 180 grit. So I'll probably go to something like 240 now on this wood. So I got a little bit carried away there, started to sort of shape it up a little bit more, and I'm kind of going now for a little bit more of a, like a barrel kind of shape, which I kind of sort of started to do. And this is what I do. I generally get something on the lathe and I start to
work at it, and I don't really know what it's going to be. Kind of got a rough idea, obviously, but don't really know the shape, and sort of it ends up what it ends up. So I sort of started to sort of shape it round, and I thought, oh, this looks quite nice. Maybe I sort of go for a little barrel looking kind of pot. So that's what I did. Right, so I'm still finishing off the bottom. Got rid of all the resin on here now. Got rid of the resin on here. We don't want any resin on these bits of wood. We want to show the wood, because the wood is what we really love. These bits in here are just, you know, kind of nice to have. You know, all the colours and stuff, which is really good. And I love colours, you know. Colours are really quite good, quite bright. It puts a smile on everyone's face, doesn't it? So I'm just going to finish this off now. I'm just going to go over with this with a bit of a light sandpaper. Right, now I'm going to put another coat of sand and sealer on this. Should be it now for the sand and sealer on the bottom anyway. But I will put a bit on here as well. This will start to be the first coat of the sand and sealer on the main base of the barrel. Look at that, that is going to look nice. Yes, love that. Right, so let's just work that in a bit. Right, there we go. So, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go with a really fine 600 grit here. So I'm only really trying to concentrate on finishing the bottom, but I do get a bit carried away and I go everywhere with it. But that's alright. I've got quite fond of using the Wood Wax 22. I used this sort of when I first started turning, because I saw quite a few people using it, and I sort of forgot about it really, and sort of just using other bits and pieces, I didn't really realise, or sort of forgot how really great this stuff is, and it really does bring up a really fantastic shine on your work. So I've gone back to using this again. I'll just show you what it would do on this piece. Right, see, there you go. See, the Wood Wax 22 will do, you know, really quite a nice job. I'm still going to finish it with the Shella Wax. Watch this shine up now. This will really shine up now. This is fantastic stuff. This is friction polish, this is. And this is, you mainly get this in the States. So in the US, you can get this quite easily, but there's only one place I know that sells this stuff in the UK, and that's the Tool Post. And that's really nice finish. So that is now finished. Now the bottom, that we can now flip this over, put it in the base, and we can put it in the chuck, and we can start to, you know, sort out what we're going to do with the lid, whether we're going to do a normal lid, which we can do. Or we can do one of those other lids with just the top that goes on there. I don't know yet what to do, but that looks quite nice. That's finished. Look at that, how that the light catches that wood. It's beautiful. Right, so that's turned around now, and it fits nicely, really nice and tight in the jaws of the chuck. Now I put that kind of recess in the bottom, in the base. So now it's whether or not we take the lid off here, which we could do. We could take the lid off here, and then we've still got the tenon on here, so we leave that on there, and then we can reverse, put that back in the chuck and finish the lid. I might do it like that actually. Or shall I take it off and do it as one of those other lids? I don't know really, I don't really know which one's best to do.
I can never really decide, you know, which lid to do. I don't know, I mean they're both quite good lids, but if I do the other lid that I normally do with the resin pots, then I've got to like make a finial type thing for it, which okay, I can make a finial. Or I do it the other way. Tell you what I could do. Could make a finial out of pencil. Someone's asked me about doing that. And depending upon whether or not you've seen the video that I'm making for you of the pencil pot, the large one, I'm doing that one as well as I'm doing this one at the same time. So that's why my videos get muddled up sometimes, because I'm kind of working on quite a few projects at the same time. I know I always say that, but I am. So someone's asked me to make a finial out of pencils, which is a good idea, whoever said that. So I'm doing that on another project that I'm showing you or making, so I could do that on this one as well. If you haven't seen that and I released this one before, then I could make a pencil finial. Anyway, it's getting late now, so I'm going to have to cut the video off for tonight, because I've got to get in, shower up, get ready for work tomorrow. But to you, there's no difference, because it's all edited, and I would have done all that, come back in the shed the next day to finish this off. Okay, you know what? I think I am going to have one of those lids that I'm going to cut off here, and we're going to have one that sort of sits in. I think I kind of like that one with a finial, and I think I am going to go for a pencil finial as well. So let's part this off now. Finial now, which I'm going to try to make out of pencils. So we're almost done. It's not quite a tight fit, this one, but a little bit of slack in it, but it's okay for what we want, you know, a little pencil pot. So now just quickly make the finial up, if I can get this made out of pencils. Now what I have for that is I've got a little pencil blank that I've made here. Sorry, not a pencil blank, but well, yeah, coloured pencils I've made into a little baby blank, so I can mount this now into the lathe and then hopefully carve a little finial out of it. And completed. I'm quite pleased with this one actually. I really like this. Whoever gave me the idea for the pencil finial, I love it, and I hope you do too. So there's the pencil finial, and that's turned out really well. You see that? There. And this is quite good as well. I kind of like, I didn't really know what I was doing, as I don't always, as I never really do. But I'm quite pleased with the way that the shapes turned out, is what I'm trying to say. I was sort of going for I was going for like a just a normal flat shape, and then I sort of started to sort of shape it into sort of like a barrel. What's that there? Oh, it's all right. And yeah, I sort of like the shape of the barrel sort of started to sort of take effect. So yeah, I quite enjoyed doing that one. It's a little bit different. The inside looks kind of funky. Let me put my light on again. Where's my light gone? Hang on. Right, now with my light on, you can see a little bit more inside there. So that looks quite nice. Still can't really see anything, can you? Rubbish light. There's a bit better. There. You can see through all the gaps and stuff. And the bottom. Lid. Yeah, it's quite nice actually. And again, I'm not bigging up my work. I hate doing that. What I'm saying is it's turned out quite well, and I'm quite pleased with the way it's turned out. I hate sort of saying, oh yeah, it looks amazing, because, I don't know, it just sounds a bit weird. But I hope you like it, and I hope you enjoyed watching me turn that little pencil pot. I'll get it up on the website if anyone wants to take it home with them. Then it'll be on the website with a few other things that I've recently been making. But yeah, I think I'm definitely going to do a bit more of the finial, the pencil finials with some of the pencil work, because I think that really sets it off. So yeah, there we go. So there's that. Other news, shop is coming along very well. I should be moving in there very soon. You'll probably start to notice some things are starting to disappear. I'm starting to take out things slowly and move them across to the new shop. So I would say probably in the next couple of videos we might be doing a new shop tour for you. So that'd be quite exciting. It is double the size of this shed, and it has been built bespoke for me. So I'm really quite pleased. I can't wait to get in there, because as I say, it's got a lot more room, and I've been able to buy a few more toys, which I can't wait to show you. What else? Ah, yes. Apparently, I'm getting old and I'm going blind, so I've got to wear glasses. So, I've gone for the Buddy Holly look. Or, I've got these ones. I'm not too sure really which ones to wear. They're only for short distance and reading, because I'm doing a lot of studying at the moment on other things, and I'm really finding it hard to sort of see close up. So it's kind of for computers and reading and things like that. Mind you, looking at it, it's surprising when you put glasses on you can see so much. Long distance I'm fine. So it's these ones, or the Buddy Holly look. I kind of like the Buddy Holly look, you know. Let me know. Thanks again for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you haven't subscribed to the channel, please hit the subscribe button. Share the video if you can. Like it and comment below. And the hamper is coming along well. Lots of people have entered that, so thanks very much, guys, for entering. I feel almost kind of bit bad now that so many people have entered, and I've only got two to give away. Kind of the opposite is what I wanted to sort of like kind of do, really. If I could give all you all hampers, I really would do. But unfortunately, there is only two, so I don't know. I suppose that's just the way it goes, but I just I don't really like being in that position, really, of letting everyone else down. But there we go. Sorry about that. But hopefully, we're you know, whoever wins the hampers will be really chuffed with them. Again, we'll announce that now. So this should be Friday's video you're watching, which is this coming Friday, which means the hamper video will be, was it next Wednesday? Or did I say 2 weeks? Oh, I don't know. I can't remember. I'm sure I'll figure it out and let you know. But it's on a Wednesday. I'll be announcing the winner. So that's it. So thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, and share.